Every few days I get a comment on my videos saying, it's not the volts that'll kill you, it's the amps. And while there's some truth to it, it's basically a load of crap and dangerously misleading. So in this video, I'm going to put on my beret and walrus mustache and bust this myth very thoroughly. Let's start out with the origin of this belief. In high school physics, everybody learns about static electricity. The classic thing the teacher shows you is a balloon charged up with static electricity and sticking to a wall, and the balloon is charged up to a couple of thousand volts with respect to the wall. Or maybe you get the example where you rub your shoes on a carpet, charge yourself up to a few thousand volts, touch a grounded piece of metal, a spark flies, and yet you still don't die. At this point, the students get confused. How can there be thousands of volts and yet no one is dying? Then the teacher delivers the infamous line, "It's not the volts that kill you, it's the amps." Now, if you interpret that statement literally, it's technically true. The static charges are a few thousand volts in magnitude, and it's ultimately the current going through your body that determines whether you live or die. Here's one of the standard safety guides showing you how much damage a few milliamps can do. Now here's the problem. Static electricity charges are completely incomparable to everyday high voltage situations when you're working with electronics. Let's start out by modeling a static electricity situation with a capacitor and a resistor. Balloons and human beings are capable of holding electric charge, but their equivalent capacitance is tiny, somewhere in the picofarad range. And I'm using a high-value series resistance in the model because obviously a rubber balloon or a human being's skin is going to have much higher resistance than a piece of copper wire. 100 picofarads and 1.5 kiloohms are a fairly standard human static discharge model. Now let's say that your body is charged 12,000 volts. It could be higher than that, but 12 kV is pretty common. The equation to find out the energy stored in a capacitor is energy equals half CV squared, so the total energy stored in the form of a static charge here is 7.2 millijoules. That's tiny. That amount of energy can't possibly do any damage to your body. Also using this model, I can show you what the current flowing through your body will be. Here's the equation that gives you the amps flowing through you versus time. If you plug in our values, you get this graph. As you can see, the theoretical peak current is 8 amps, which is extremely dangerous. However, as I mentioned before, the total energy stored is so low that the current flowing through you decays so quickly, it drops to almost zero in literally a microsecond. So that explains why when you experience a static shock, it's painful, but since it's over so quickly, it doesn't damage you. Okay, so now you know exactly why a high voltage static charge won't kill you. It basically boils down to a tiny amount of capacitance, a large amount of equivalent series resistance, and low total stored energy. Now let's compare that to situations you would encounter when working with electronics. A high voltage power supply can deliver lethal amounts of current continuously, or in one big burst when the output capacitor is discharged. A model for a power supply like this is a constant voltage source with a low series resistance. In fact, the series resistance is usually so low we might as well pretend it's non-existent. Okay, so let's say you have someone who's not very bright, who's touching the wires of a 300 volt power supply because he believes that the volts won't kill you, it's only the amps that will. Well, what determines the amount of current? First up, it's a common mistake to think that just because a constant voltage power supply is capable of delivering, for example, 1 amp, that means it'll push 1 amp through everything it's connected to. Otherwise, you could kill people with a phone charger. The amp rating on a power supply only tells you the maximum current the power supply is capable of handling. The thing that determines the amount of current flowing through the circuit is the load. The load only draws as much current as it needs at a given voltage. The equation we use here is very simple. It's just Ohm's law. Take the voltage, divide it by the resistance of whatever you're connecting it to, and you'll get the current. The resistance of the human body is somewhere in the 1 kiloohm to 30 kiloohm range, depending on how wet your hands are. For now, I'm going to use 3 kiloohms as an example. And by the way, you can't reliably measure body resistance with a simple multimeter, so that's why you won't get the same values if you measure yourself at home. Okay, so let's apply Ohm's law with our friend over here. 300 volts divided by 3 kiloohms equals 100 milliamps. If you look that up in the safety chart, you can see that that's enough current to screw up your heart and nervous system, so he shouldn't be touching those wires. Ohm's law is a linear relationship, meaning that for any given body resistance, the more volts you have, the more amps you'll have. And that's why it's misleading to say that it's not the volts that'll kill you, it's the amps. The volts directly determine the amps. There's no way around it. On top of that, the resistance of the human body actually decreases as voltage increases. Because as you start penetrating the outer layers of dead skin, your inner organs and blood will have a resistance of a few hundred ohms instead of a few kilo-ohms, so things just get worse and worse with higher voltages. Large high-voltage capacitors are equally dangerous. In my capacitor replacement tutorial video, I mentioned that a 200-volt capacitor could kill you, and some people didn't believe me. Well, let's take a look at the math. This is a real capacitor here, not a static charged person, and we've got a capacitance of 560 microfarads. Since this is a large capacitor used in a power supply, I can estimate that the equivalent series resistance is going to be very low. I might as well ignore it completely. And let's assume that the cap is charged to its max of 200 volts. Using our stored energy equation again, we can see that this capacitor can hold up to 11.2 joules of energy. That's over 1,500 times more energy than a typical static shock. You don't need to be good at math to know that that's going to hurt like hell. A young man would probably survive it with a burn mark, but if you've got a weak heart, it'll kill you. Now, what might surprise you is that you don't even have to get into the hundreds of volts range for things to start being painful. Here I have my bench power supply set to 30 volts, and I'm measuring the current flowing through my body. It's roughly 1 milliamp, and I can already feel it. It's a slightly annoying tingle. From personal experience, I can tell you that 50 volts is where things start getting really painful. Remember what I said, as the voltage increases, the effective resistance of your body decreases, so the danger gets exponentially worse. And if your skin gets pierced by a sharp wire or a high voltage arc, the resistance of your body drops dramatically, so you don't even have to have hundreds of volts before things start getting dangerous. A good rule of thumb is that voltages higher than just 30 volts are dangerous, and you should take safety precautions and make sure you don't touch anything. And with the exception of static electricity, you should treat every high voltage source as if it could kill you. One exception to the rule is taser circuits, which produce hundreds of thousands of volts, but they deliberately have resistors inside them to limit the current to non-lethal levels. But as we all know, that doesn't always work out as planned, so you should still treat them as deadly. In conclusion, in almost every situation, the volts directly determine the amps flowing through your body. If anyone tells you that volts won't kill you, they're an idiot.